Welcome to this edition of Crydom TechLab. Solid-state relay users can ensure the reliability of their relays or contactors by observing some simple rules when installing them in their applications. To help them, this Crydom TechLab presentation will demonstrate how to correctly install a panel-mounted solid-state relay to a panel or heatsink. Solid-state relays are preferred for many applications because of their superior performance characteristics versus other switching technologies. Life expectancy and reliability are only two of them, among many others. You can increase the reliability of your solid-state relay or contactor by following three simple rules when installing the SSR in your application. The first one is to manage thermal power dissipation. SSRs and SSCs generate thermal power dissipation during the conduction of load current. This power dissipation depends upon the relay selected and its end application, but approximates 1 watt per ampere of current through the load. Efficiently removing this energy from the relay helps ensure its reliability. The mounting surfaces of SSRs rated above 5 amps also typically serve as a transfer area to move thermal energy out of the relay into the surrounding environment. These surfaces should be flat and free of any interfering materials. Each SSR should be mounted to a thermally conductive surface, such as a panel or extruded aluminum heatsink. The area of the panel or heatsink where the SSR is to reside must also be flat and clear of any interfering materials. The panel or heatsink should be made out of a thermally conductive material, such as aluminum, although steel panels may also be acceptable under certain circumstances. The size of the heatsink should be chosen based on the load current, ambient temperature, and selected SSR. The calculation of the minimum size required for any given application is reasonably simple and the subject of another Crydom TechLab video. Rule 2 is to always use thermal interface material. Once the SSR and heatsink are selected, the next step is to place a thermal interface material between the SSR and flat heatsink surface prior to SSR mounting. This can be a pre-manufactured pad, such as the Crydom HSB2, or a thermal compound, such as Dow Corning 340. Thermal pads are preferred since they offer very consistent performance and only require modest attention to installation, whereas thermal compound must be properly installed and thickness controlled very carefully. Thermal pads can be placed on the heatsink or SSR, or provided pre-installed on the SSR by Crydom. Generally an option identified by a suffix H on the end of the SSR part number. Crydom offers a variety of thermal pads with and without adhesive for installation between the SSR and heatsink. If you choose to use an adhesive pad, be sure to remove the protective film or backing from the adhesive side of the thermal pad before placing it on the SSR or heatsink, and be careful to minimize any entrapment of air at the interface. Additional information on thermal pad performance and selection is available at crydom.com. Third and last is to carefully mount and wire the SSR. Place the SSR on the heatsink or panel, being careful not to bend the thermal pad. Install the mounting screws and begin tightening them to the specified torque. It is recommended that the screws be lightly tightened by alternating between them until snug. Once snug, use a torque wrench to tighten them to the specified torque. Refer to the specific SSR datasheet available on the website for the recommended values. Once mounted, the control and load wires can be attached to the SSR terminals. As with the mounting screws, the terminal screws should be torqued to the specified values. For best reliability, it is advisable to periodically retorque both the mounting screws and the termination screws. The wire termination screws tend to loosen with heat cycling. Ready to install your SSR? Let's take one last quick look. Solid-state relays and contactors generate thermal power dissipation during their conduction of load current, which must be managed using a panel or extruded aluminum heatsink. Remember to use thermal interface material to help move thermal energy out of the relay onto the mounting surface. When mounting, Be careful not to bend the thermal pad and be sure to use the recommended torque when tightening the mounting and wire termination screws. Increasing the reliability of your solid-state relay or contactor is as easy as 1, 2, 3. If you have any further questions, please contact Crydom Tech Support. Thanks for watching this edition of Crydom Tech Lab.